Steps were taken without regret, for it was never possible to change a destiny unknown. For those seeking refuge, one problem simply replaced another. Though he was relieved to see family, Uncle Ben's first thought was of scavenging the things he needed to repair the ramshackle wagon. Summoners in a circle. Surely nothing would come from it. Had they only been quicker. Ha! Rhea's mercy can make the impossible possible, is all part of this world. Shopkeeper said he would like to offer a discount for his rescue, but there had not been many customers lately. With supplies in hand, Ben began repairing the cart as the refugees waited, anxious to continue their trek. Thank you. not-so-innocent game of chance and memory.
Let's go.
summoners in a circle. Surely nothing would come from it. A greater enemy, but also a greater reward. Lay in ruin. Serene prayers had fallen on deaf ears, leaving a voyage of hope with none at all. The monster's eyes lacked remorse, or even the slightest hint of reason. No one can always be there in time. A sad truth that no hero learns easily. Goddess of anguish, a protector, being of stone made living. Finally free of the corruption's hold, Anea Dyer gazed upon the Bergson, her emerald eyes weary with exhaustion. Spirit's words took life, forming images to reveal what was hidden from the Bergsons. And us, Spirits Three, knelt before the mountain god U to swear fealty. Our wills were set on peace. His was set on testing ours. And as the test drew to a close, we discovered our wretched ending. As the mountain god exacted vengeance on the children of Rhea Dana and tainted Rhea with the corruption. Thus was another truth revealed to the Bergson, but many more were hidden still. Questions were abundant in the Bergson's mind. If the mountain god was the source of the corruption, what had made him wreak such havoc? How had no one known about him before? They needed to find the next spirit, as maybe they had an answer to some of their questions. More truths awaited them in the land of the winds. Mary's worry over bringing a child into this harsh world would not prevent John from making bad jokes. He would say, "The baby does not seem at all worried," which was exactly what helped her keep calm.